Good afternoon, everyone. Myself Prashant Dave, and we will continue with the LaTeX part of today's session. So before going to details what the LaTeX is, in engineering and in science, we do two parts. We do research, another thing we do is the documentation part. So whatever we do in research is put in the documentation part. In documentation also we put the results and all, but most of the time what we do, we write that document in a particular format, like what the title should be and what font it should be. So most of the time we spend on the formatting the text. So to save that time, we should use the LaTeX. LaTeX is basically typesetting environment. And see, generally all people use MS Office for the document creation and all. The approach in MS Office is you write some document and then arrange it according to given given performa. Now, since it takes lot of time, we are shifting to LaTeX. Since we are shifting to LaTeX and we are hoping we save a lot of time, we will have to follow different approach toward LaTeX. So we will have to think out of the box. So if someone tells me how to write a document, so what I'll do? In general, so what I want to create a very good document is I just define initially something like my title should come in this particular format, this particular font, remaining text should come in that particular font. So at the beginning of a document, I define this thing. Now wherever title appears or something appears, I just put some tag to it, like title. Now my document should take care of it automatically afterward. So in LaTeX, what we have different parts. First is the introductory part called the preamble. So basically LaTeX is a typesetting program. Anything like you can add figure, maths and everything you can add to it. So it's pronounced as a LaTeX. So you can write your papers, your reports, maybe your PhD thesis report, you may even write books in it. Generally across the world, books and everything, whatever you get printed, it's done in LaTeX only. Now, so suppose if you take a look at the slide, there is a long formula given. If I am to type this in MS Office, it will take a lot of time. I may use some math tool to write it, but in LaTeX, if I know LaTeX, I can use it very easily. Okay, so suppose I have a document in which I want to write what is the title, what is the author, date, then generate will come like you have extract, you write something in your section, then the appendix, references, you want to have tables, figures in it. So what we will do, we will see how to write a basic document in LaTeX and how we can use that LaTeX file to generate PDF out of it. Okay, so basically in the initial, when we started, I said that we will have preamble. And wherever suppose title occur, we will put a tag to it. So basically what we are doing, we are marking that particular text. Now, so LaTeX is basically a document based markup language. So whatever you want to have, you just mark it, put some tag to it, and then it will be processed accordingly. So whatever you can focus on the content rather than the appearance, like how to set the margin, where to put the figure and all. So someone asked a question here, how to enter into LaTeX. So basically what we will do, suppose you will write the document in a particular editor, any editor you can use to write the text, and using a PDF LaTeX command, we will compile the document. So what are the different editors that can be used? You can use, as we looked in the previous session, we use nano editor to write a text. We can use any other editor like gedit, we can use vim also. It is recommended that initially you use gedit and then move on to different editors according to your needs. So we will start with the few of the examples, like how to begin in LaTeX. So first of all, I have to write the preamble of the of LaTeX.
1.10.
No, this is 10. No, we'll show them that thing.
We'll compile it. Okay.
Done. So basically, if you take a look look at this example, so first line says what is the document class. So in the curly braces, it's written that it's an article. You can have different type of documents. You can you can have a report, you can have a letter. For this particular session, we will be using document class article, because we will be creating an article using some text, some mathematical formula, using some figures into it. Now, once the class of the document has been defined using document class keyword, then we'll have to tell LaTeX that documentation has begun. For that, we write begin document. Since we have begun the document, there also should be a corresponding end document. So we will have begin document and the end document. Between this, whatever text we want to have, we can write that text as it is. This is very basic example in which everything is default. The font which will come is default. So we have defined the document class, we have written that start the document, end the document, and whatever text we wanted to have in the document. Now it completes half of the task. We have written the document. Now to compile it, we will write PDF LaTeX in the command prompt and followed by the file name. In this case is example1.tex. So when we compile it, it says your transcript written on example1.log and a lot of information it gives. So what it does, it creates a PDF file with the same name as a text file. So to open the PDF file, we will use the events command. The use of events command was shown in the first session. So after compilation, LaTeX has created a document in PDF. It's only one page because the text was too less in this. We have just written a line. This is my first LaTeX document. Now, so what do we need to run the LaTeX? LaTeX is basically a typesetting environment. It compiles the text written in any editor. So if you want to start, so someone is asking that PDF LaTeX command is used in a shell but command not found. So it is because the LaTeX is not installed in your com. So I suggest you try just LaTeX instead of PDF LaTeX command in the shell, followed by the file name which you want to compile. So if you want to start working on this, type gedit in the console and the file name. If the file does not exist or it shows file is not there, just use touch to create the file and then open the file using gedit editor. We can show them gedit example. Okay. So in the gedit, you can edit the text which is written in the file. Since we in this we don't have much text, only one line. Now see every markup in the LaTeX start with the backslash, and every comment is commented by percentage sign. So if I write percent and anything else, anything after that will be commented, it won't be compiled. So two backslashes add together are used for inserting the output, inserting new line in the output. An empty line marks the beginning of a new paragraph in the LaTeX document. See, you can go through initial few slides by yourself, because it contains basic information like how to add new line to the document and all. I will go more into the detail of what the document class can do. So in the document class, we used article. As I said earlier, you can use report, you can use book, you can use slides, you can use letter. There are optional argument also. If you look at the slide, there are 12 PT, A4 paper and draft. So it says that 12 point size A4 paper to be used for printing. But anything in the square bracket are optional parameters. Now to the document which was created, which contains only one line, now we would like to add some title, then the author's name and the date on which the document is created. So we will open another file, which is basically an addendum to the previous file. So in this, we have more information. We have document class article as it is. It says title. Title for the text is Python. Then author. Author says who has written this whole text is the Wikipedia. And make title. Make title, wherever you put the make title, it will create the title there. Then again begin document and the end document, and between these we will write whatever text we want to have. I hope it's visible to everyone now. So we have the preamble. Preamble contains document class, then the title, what is the author, then again begin document, end document. Between these two we can write the text which we want to have it in our PDF. So again, once we have written this, we need to compile it. For compiling, we will use again PDF LaTeX followed by the file name which we want to compile. Yeah, so once when we compile, we are seeing an error, like it shows error at the make title. So make title should come. So basically any title should come within the document. It's outside the document. In our LaTeX document which we opened using gedit, we have put that make title markup before the document begins. That is why it's showing an error. When it shows an error, to exit that, type X and then enter. You will be directed to the command prompt again. Now to correct this, we will open the document again and put the make title markup within the document itself. Now let's see whether it works or not. Now it works. So when you successfully compile the document, at the bottom you will see this message that output written on so and so PDF file, also transcript written on example2.log. So when you compile something, you will see many files are created. Each file has its own significance. We will come to it, but for the time being The direct way to look whether we have got the right file, whether it has been compiled successfully, one way is to look at the screen. Second thing, open the PDF and then check. So in the PDF, it has created the title, it has written who has created this document, as in author we mentioned Wikipedia, and in other also it put the date. It was created on September 3rd, 2011, and then the text which we have put in our tech file. Now similarly, most of the paper will have the abstract. So how to put abstract into it? We will also see. Whatever we want, we can put in our main tech document. Like we put the title, we put the author name, we put the date. Similarly, we can put the abstract also. We will just see how to do it. So as you can see, we again in the preamble everything remains the same. We add one more thing, that is the abstract. For that, we, as you know, that when you start the document, you write the abstract. So for writing the abstract, we will have to tell LaTeX that this is abstract part. So we have to put a markup for that. So we write begin abstract, then the content of the abstract, and then end abstract. So we started abstract part, we ended abstract part. After that, whatever comes, it will be a part of the main text. Again, once we have written this, we have to compile it again. Whatever we write, we have to compile it again and again. So for that, similarly, PDF LaTeX followed by file name. Again, it will give you many files. We will check PDF file using events command to see whether the output is in the required format or not. So we put the markup that this is abstract. While compilation, LaTeX took care of it and put this thing as an abstract. Then from after that, it put the main document. In the whole thing, if you noticed, I didn't care at all about my what should be the margin, what should be the formatting style, whether it should be bold, it should not be bold, abstract should come where, in the middle it should come or not. I didn't care anything about that. It was taken care by the LaTeX itself. Only thing which I did, I mentioned that this is abstract, put the text, and it did it for me. So now we will move on. Previously we saw how to write the abstract. Now what if the main document contains different section? So we will take a look in the tech file. See, every document requires some commenting. How to comment anything in the LaTeX is by putting some putting percentage sign before the line or before the text we want to comment. So if you take a look at the text, so it initially I have put some comment using percentage sign. Then again the same thing, we need to define the document class. I have mentioned specifically 12 point size, and then article, then the title is LaTeX, then the author, that Fossey team, that is us. I can specify the date which it was created initially also, whatever date I want to specify. Suppose I don't want to specify today's date, so what will I write? Whatever other date I may want to write it. So in this case, I have put August 2010. Again, make title. Now we will start with the document, then the make title, and then the table of contents. One more thing which we have now is the table of content. Another thing which we look for, in this how to write subsection in this. So, again we have abstract, this is a sample document, that is a text of the abstract. So, begin abstract and the end abstract, then we just write section. Section first is the introduction, whether it is the first since it is appeared first time, it will be considered the first section. Next time where the section keyword appears, then it will be second section. So, when we create the PDF using this tag document, introduction will be first section, structural elements will be second section. Then we can also write subsections in this. So, subsection is document class. Within the section structural elements, there will be subsection known as document class. Again, continuing those subsections, there will be again subsections, their titles, text for those subsections, and then finally end document. So, we started the document again defining document class, then the title, author, date, whatever you wanted to put, begin the document. Again in the document first, we want to have the title of and author also, we wrote make title, then the table of contents. We have written table of contents also, but we have not used table of contents anywhere in the text. We will see in the coming few documents how to use the table of contents also. Now, once we have written it, how to compile it? So, compile it PDF LaTeX followed by which file you want to compile. So, it again says successfully output written on example6.pdf, transcript written on example6.log. So, if you just type ls, if you remember, will give you the list of files available in that directory. So, apart from PDF file also, it will give you different files like example6.log, whatever the file name .log.ogs.pdf and also. Each one has its own significance, we will take a look at that also after some time. Now, to see whether section has been created successfully or not, we will open the file and see. To open it, we will use events. So, if you take a look, first thing was the LaTeX was the title, author was the Fawcett team, and it was created on August 2010. We mentioned this date in the tag document itself. Now, then the abstract part, if you notice, there is a contents file. This contents, they written the contents in bold. This came because we mentioned. If you take a look at your document again, initially we defined make title and then title, then we have told it to write table of contents. That is why it just created contents there. Then the abstract part. And then the first, so introduction came in bold, automatically it put number 1. Second section was structural elements, so 2 was assigned as the section to it, section number to it. Then subsection was document class, so it was assigned at 2.1, then 2.2, 2.3, whatever we want to have, we can write it accordingly. Since appendices was the subsection or subsection of section 2.2, so it came as 2.2.1. Now, we will take a look at the slides again. So, we have seen how to write section and subsection into it. So what if I do not want to have I do not want to number any section, how do I do? I just put a star there to prevent it from putting the number of the section. So if I have the document, if I have this document, in this I do not want to put the section to the introduction part, so I just put a star there. Then let's see what happens when we compile it. And so the introduction part, now it does not have any section in it. Since we put a star, introduction was not considered as a starting or no number was put, it is without number. So we put the star after the section, we write section star, then whatever we want to write in the curly or the braces. So this was done to prevent the numbering. Now number start from the next section. So in the PDF if you look, so previously it was structure elements was second section, now it is become first section, and the introduction it does not have the section number in it. Now we will move on. So this was one type of a document. Now you can write your report or a book. Your document class will change accordingly. Since book contain different chapters, so instead of section you may prefer to write chapter 1. If you take a look at the slides, chapter in braces is written as 1, so title of the chapter will come as 1. Previously we wrote section and then whatever the title of the section was. So basically this chapter word is a markup which says the title of the chapter is 1 and this 1 is a chapter. Similarly, there is a markup for that, there is appendix. So if I want to have appendix, so if you take a look at this document, we use subsection appendix, appendices. So it was basically, we are not, what the markup we are using to appendix is subsection. If we give markup appendix to it, it will just list it at the end in form of appendix. You can try this out, this command, by typing this appendix and then compile and see what happens. You may try it out. Now see, most of the scientific documents have 2-3 things very in generality. They have figures, they have tables. So how to have table, how to list the table of content in this? So when we compiled, we noted there are different document or different files that were created apart from PDF file itself. One was .toc in .toc format, file name .toc is was the extension. So toc stands for table of contents. You can check this by typing ls in the screen. So in your document, if you have used table of contents somewhere, backward slash table of contents, it will, the file will be created since we have not used it. See, more on the table of contents can be discussed on the forum. Now there is one thing, like, see, suppose I have some text, how can I emphasize that text? I want to make it bold, how can I do it? So we will work more on the example, or this particular example, in which we created different sections. Suppose I want to make something bold. So how will I write? I write EMPH. EMPH means emphasize this. So remember, in the section introduction, we are emphasizing LaTeX. And how to test it, whether it is worked or not, we will have to compile it. And to compile, we'll use PDF LaTeX. And to check it again, we will have to open the PDF file. So we have emphasized it, it has come in italics. Similarly, if we want to align that text in the leftmost margin, we can use flush left, flush right, or the center. So suppose if I just want to, like, for emphasizing particular text, I use backslash, the command which I want to use, and then braces. Similarly, anything, like, there are different commands, like, if you want to bold you want to make, you can type bf command for that. Backslash, bf, anything in braces. So similarly, there is a command text bf which will make your font bold face. So there are different commands in LaTeX. The best way to learn LaTeX is to type out more and more command, then only you will be able to remember as well as use those commands. Now we will see in another file how to enumerate different lines. So before that, if there are some questions, we can attend to it. So please ask your questions. One question I can see on the chat is, the person using it got a fatal error during the PDF file creation. See, there may be different sorts of errors. So while looking what exactly output you are getting, then only it can be decided what kind of error you are getting.
Okay, the next question is from VP College of Engineering, Baramati. Yeah, please tell.
Hello sir, my question is, all the times while writing the papers or the manuscripts for the books, so some type of the or the same things are going to repeat again and again.
Yeah.
So can we create a package for the same and we can use it everywhere?
Of course. You can write all the required things in one file and input that particular file at each place you require it to come. So no need to type the text that is required to come again. So always keep in mind, not just for LaTeX, but for Bash, LaTeX, Python, all the modules that we will teach, any repetitive work can always be automated in a very simple way. Yeah. So there will never be a reason for you to repeat any task in a routine way. Okay, so your question can be answered by using the command called input. Okay, is there any other question by you before we go to the next question?
No, sir. No question. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. The next question is from Saint Joseph College, Kerala.
Is the output file exactly PDF, or we can have any other open document format, something like that?
Yeah, good question. Thank you very much. So first, there used to be only LaTeX, which made something called a DVI file, which is called device independent file, to the best of my understanding, which one often made it into a PS file. More recently, we have this PDF LaTeX. Recently, I mean 6, 7, 8 years, we have PDF LaTeX that converts it to PDF, because PDF is I do not know the full reason why PDF is a preferred one. It allows us for hyperlinks, it allows us for searchability within the PDF document, unlike some PostScript file, unlike PS files. So there is at least DVI, PS, and PDF. These are the three formats I can think of. Yeah, sorry. Do you have any more questions?
Is it possible to convert back to text files, PDF
no,
files
no.
to text files?
No,
files.
No. If somebody gives us a PDF file, we can copy the text using a mouse, let's say, and paste it into a plain editor, but the formulas will not get converted to tech form. Yeah, and also from a tech file, it is possible to also convert it to HTML and perhaps also to RST. But if you want to know if it can be converted to a Word form, then that is the answer to that is no. Yeah, so it can be converted to various other forms, HTML for example, RST for example. RST we are not planning to cover in this course, but that's also an extremely powerful way of describing various documents. So it is possible to RST, HTML, DVI, PS, and PDF. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Next question is from Shastra University, Tanjavur.
You want to have a section number along with the chapter number. That is, suppose if the section number is 1, if the chapter is 2, I want to have a section number 2.1.
Yes. This is an extremely useful feature. Often we would like that section number also has chapter number as part of it. Inside chapter 2, section should be 2.1, 2.2, 2.3. Equation numbers also perhaps should have chapter number, section number. All this is very much possible. Yeah, the default section numbers having chapter numbers is possible in document class report. Yeah, so if it is not the default, then we will have a look and tell you how to change it. But such a change is very much possible. The next question is from Don Bosco, Guwahati.
Hello, is it possible to change the font style to Times New Roman or Calibri like that?
Of course, plenty of fonts are available, and the fonts can be changed to precisely what font you want. Yeah, so one has to just use the right package. One can use Roman, Times, plenty of fonts of different sizes also. So all those things are possible. So there are some questions on chat. How to convert JPEG to EPS? Okay. Then there is a question, LaTeX editors rather than G8 and VI customized for LaTeX. Yeah. So there is one question about LaTeX editors can be used directly. This is very much correct. One can use something called Kyle, which is so-called integrated design environment. There are some development environments which are integrated. For example, Kyle is one of them, K-I-L-E. This is also free, open source. You can install it on Linux. Also on Windows, there is something called MikTeX, I think, within the same.
Technique Center.
There's also a Technique Center. Within the same big editor, you can also have LaTeX and PDF LaTeX capabilities. You can include various packages. All kinds of manipulation is possible within these environments, and if that is easier for you, we recommend that for you. Yeah. So they are not the very simplest plain editors, but they also are more customized for LaTeX. That is indeed true. Thanks for bringing this to our notice. There are two more editors that are LaTeX customizable. Yeah, just a minute. I will give the mic to Shrikant.
So there are two more IDs for LaTeX. One is INI So you have to download one plugin for LaTeX for in Guinea, and the other one is LYX. So LYX document processor, that is the high level LaTeX front end.
So those editors also can be used, and they are more powerful for LaTeX purposes. Another question is how to convert JPEG to EPS. So this is also a very relevant question. Often our figures that we want to include are given to us as JPEG forms, or they are given to us as GIF. Yeah. So these all figures, if you want to include into our PDF file, maybe it helps to convert it to another form. So one open source package that can convert almost any image format to any other image format is GIMP. Yeah. There's also to convert image formats, GIMP is fairly versatile. One can do almost anything. But also I should tell, LaTeX and PDF LaTeX will allow you to include JPEG files directly. It is not required, the figures don't have to always be in PDF or EPS. JPEG, GIF, these are also acceptable. Only for example, use package graphics is what he used in his LaTeX in the start. Some such packages have to be used by use package command. Any other questions on chat? Please type the names of the LaTeX editors. So we will type these names on Moodle and send it to all. Yeah. If somebody of you already has followed this, if you have heard of this, you only type it on Moodle forum and initiate the discussion. Okay, so if there are no more questions, then we'll continue with LaTeX. And so Prashant will continue with this.
So now we will continue with this. So far we have covered how to write the abstract, how to create different section, then the subsections into that, how to emphasize certain text. So basically LaTeX is very vast field, all kind of text manipulation you want to do, you can do anything, but you have to explore them more to do it. Now one of the common thing which we face in that document is like you want to put some bullets or number something. So for that we use enumerate. So if you take a look at the example, so in this start with the document class article, then begin document, there is some text again, then there is a begin enumerate. So now the when I compile or anyone compiles, LaTeX will know now this is the point when the enumeration starts. Then what is the first item? So for that we write backslash item. Backslash item says that this is the first item. So first enumerate item, whatever text you want to put, you can put here for the purpose to understand this, we have just written first enumerated item. Similarly, second and the third one. Again, in the item itself, we can start we can write itemizing different lines also, like first item, second item, and then again in the items we can write again more itemize more, then end itemize, again end itemize, and end enumerate. So whatever we start has to end. We started begin document, this has to end. We started enumerating something, that has to end. We started itemizing something, that has to end. Later we see if we write an equation also, so we will write begin equation, so it should have end equation also. So once we have written this, we will compile it using PDF LaTeX. And we will see how the output looks like. If you look at the PDF, it says first whatever text we put, then we have first item, that is first enumerator item, then the second and third, and within the third we itemize more text. So enumerate will give you numbers while itemize will give dots or hyphen or whatever whatever put in the settings. So first item, second item, then third item, then the third item again contains some item, sub items you can say. So first sub item, second sub item, third and fourth sub item. So whatever we want to have an item, itemize, we can itemize, we can enumerate everything. Now we will see how to write simple equations. Before going to the equations, if I want to write some footnotes, I will just write backslash footnote followed by something in braces, whatever I want to put, it will come as footnote. So before telling you how to explaining you or discussing how to write the equation, we will see how to put the figures into it. Figures is also very important part of our documents. So if you look at the example, preamble remains the same, begin document, but if you notice there is a use package, I have the keyword use package has been used. And in the brackets I have written graphics. So basically it uses two packages, one is GRAPHICS, another is GRAPHICX. So LaTeX gives some basic things. If you want to have some advanced feature, you can use different packages which comes with the LaTeX itself. So you can understand basically these are a kind of toolboxes which gives you additional features to use. I use this in my document because I wanted to insert some figure into it. In the directory in which this example is or this tech file is, there is a figure loin_orig.png. It's some random figure. Now again, begin document is required, end document is required because I want to put some text. Then if you look at this, include graphics, then some parameters in square brackets, these are optional parameters. Then in braces, the file name which you want to add to your PDF or your file or document. This include graphics will include this. I want to have some more add more option to it, like what will be the caption of this figure. What there is one more thing called label, how will it come into picture, we will see. So first include graphics will include this figure. The line just written just above that, starting with backslash caption, is the caption of the figure, like backslash caption CTA and loin, then CTA and loin drawing by Duan BB whatever. Now again there is a line where label figure colon loin is written. I have assigned a label to this figure. In my whole document, I can refer to this particular figure by giving reference to the label that is assigned as loin. How does this referring a figure works, we will see when we compile the document. So if we take a look at this again, initially we began the document, then put some text, then we gave the figure backslash reference ref figure loin. Basically I will be giving some reference to the figure at this place. So the figure, then the reference to the figure is a drawing by Duane Bibi. Then begin figure, label, caption, include graphics. Since we begin the figure, we have to end the figure also. Then again the end document. we will see how it works in compiling. So it has done successfully. Now, if you take a look at the figure, now so a loin image was inserted in the figure in the document, and also it is whatever text we have put into this. But if you notice, when we started the document, we write this line. We wrote the line. This document contains a figure. This figure is a drawing by Duane Bibi at the start, and then after that we inserted the figure. But in the final document, it is coming above that line. So the reason is, in LaTeX, if we do not specify, if we do not force it to place the figure where we have actually written the include graphics command or begin figure end figure, it will optimize your space. So if you take a look at the slides, there is written compile it twice. The reason behind compiling it twice is that your figure may appear anywhere in the document, and reference may appear anywhere in the document. Suppose your reference come before the actual figure has come in the document, then when you compile first, it just note down what are the labels. In the second compilation, it put the label where it has been referred. It gives the it correlates these two. That is why you need to compile it twice. Now suppose I have written some code in C++ or in Scilab or in Python or in any other language. I just want to put the code directly in the document. So how do I do? There is a command called verbatim. Verbatim means do whatever is written as it is. Don't change anything at all. When we write the preamble of the document, we say make 12 point, make such size. It should be that thing. This thing or that thing. But when we write verbatim anywhere in the document itself, after whatever after that verbatim command, whatever comes will be written as it is. More thing by which we can insert our codes using listings packages. So we have already seen what is the significance of using different packages for including graphics into the figure. Similarly, listing packages if you use this listing packages, codes written in different languages can be put in the document itself. Like if you remember, when there was a for example in the bash session, there was a for loop example which contains cat, which was highlighted as a blue. It was pointed out at that time also. So when I use this listing packages, and in this I have to put some additional argument also to use this package, then certain keywords of particular language are highlighted. It gives a nice appearance to the whole document. So at that time, cat was a particular command of bash that was highlighted, because all these slides and everything, they have been created using LaTeX. So for the figures, I already explained that you can use package graphics, then the include graphics command can be used. Then there are some optional arguments. As we see in the include graphics, there was some optional argument in the square bracket, like scale 0.8 angle 30. You can also have some arguments like what will be the height of the figure, what will be the width of the figure and all, but these are optional. When you start using this, you will realize how to use them in effective manner. Similarly, angle is 30. So in the document or the PDF which I created using to demonstrate how to add a figure into a later document, the angle is specified as 30. So it means the image was rotated by 30 degrees. So also, as I said earlier, it optimized the location of the figure when we inserted it. It is possible to fix the position, but we have to write some additional character or known as specifier in the begin figure and the end figure keywords. Like in the begin figure, if I can write T, B, H. So accordingly, it will do place the figure. Like if I write T, it will place the figure at the top of the page, B for bottom of the page, then H for where the command appears in the source code, and exclamation mark if I use, it will override LaTeX internal parameters for good position. So it will optimize it. So you can take a look and you can just try it out. How does it work? What difference it makes if I write T? What difference it make if I write B, H, P and all? We all also have seen how to write the caption and how to write the references, how to label the images. And one thing you should note is the figures are auto numbered. We do not have to worry like it is figure so and so, figure 1, figure 2, figure 3, figure 4 and all. It is also possible to create table in a LaTeX document. So the typeset is the label.
One important thing is we are never going to give explicit numbers to equations, we are not going to give explicit numbers to footnotes, to section numbers, chapter numbers, tables, figures. This is really important. Why? Because if you think that equation number, some equation was equation 4.2 and you refer to that equation again as 4.2, but then you might put another equation later when you are rewriting this before this equation, and then this equation will be 4.3, yeah, and we do not want that situation that we are referring to the wrong equation. So we will always use that label and ref. Similarly for figures, tables, always the numbering is given by LaTeX when you compile it, and that number is to be picked by using this label and ref combination. Yeah. So for each figure you will use only one label, that same label can be referenced any number of times, and each particular label you give should be given only once, otherwise there will be a conflict. Similarly, you can look up this table environment, you will also put up some sample tech files having a table environment. Now when you have a table environment, it is very important to say that inside each table, inside each column, things should be justified to the left or to the center, or they should be in paragraph mode. This particular symbol which we said is extremely important, which is a pipe in bash script, produces a vertical line between these columns. You may or may not want a vertical line, but if you put the pipe, then there will be a line. H line is for putting a horizontal line between rows, while the pipe is a vertical line between columns. So in LaTeX, one does not write the list of tables explicitly, the list of tables is created. Similarly, list of figures also created depending on where you want it, just like we already saw table of contents. At the same place after table of contents, one can also say list of tables. Please note it is all one word, yeah, and then the tables list is created. Like table of contents, list of tables and list of figures also, for them to give the correct page number, one has to LaTeX it twice, yeah, LaTeX, PDF LaTeX, whichever you are using, you have to do it at least twice. That is when all the labels will refer to the correct page numbers. The strength of LaTeX is in typesetting math, in typesetting formulae, yeah. So this is where it is extremely useful. So AMS is a American Mathematical Society, and they have come up with fonts for all mathematical symbols. So one should use package AMS math at the top. So all these use packages are typically called preamble, they are used before the begin document. to have any math symbol. So one of the chat questions is, what is the advantage of LaTeX over Adobe PDF? So LaTeX, no other package can beat LaTeX for math symbols. That is precisely what we are doing here. Any detailed questions of comparisons can be taken up on Moodle forum. So please pay attention to the discussion about math symbols while we are discussing that. So you will put any math formula, anything mathematical between dollar signs. The first dollar sign starts the math mode, as we say, and the second dollar sign will end the math mode. You can also put the mathematical symbol between such brackets, yeah, between slash round bracket open and slash round bracket close. You can use B matrix for building a matrix. So B matrix is very similar to a tabular environment. You can use ands to separate columns inside each row, and for the next row you will put two slashes in entire LaTeX environment means next line, new line, instead of B. So this B matrix is you can use in slash begin B matrix also. Similarly, you can use also these environments, matrix, P matrix, capital B matrix. You can take an example and see the exact difference. So, depending on how the bracket on the side opens and closes, these have small variations. We might want brackets, we might want matrix with square brackets on the left and right. That is when we will use B matrix. Most important in math symbols is superscripts, subscripts, more complicated a superscript inside a subscript. All this is possible very easily using hat for superscript, underscore for subscript. All this will work only in math mode. Please keep note. If you have a long list of characters all sitting in the superscript, then please enclose them between curly brackets. So summation, integration are also symbols that have a superscript, subscript, and they will either put it right above the summation sign or right below the summation sign, depending on the math mode involved. If you have many equations, then equation environment is better than just dollar dollar. Equation array also neatly numbers different equations inside a set of equations, inside multiple equations. Fractions, extremely useful, slash frac, curly brackets. So curly brackets are very important in math mode. Overall in LaTeX, slash frac is a command that takes two arguments. First one is numerator, second one is denominator. You can also write square root. You can also have fifth root, the square root sign with the number 5 at the very key place. So those you can write using slash sqrt command. So very important is that in math mode there is no space. Yeah, space, if you leave more space, as I said, inside LaTeX, whether you leave one space or 10 spaces, they are all the same as just one space. Also, whether you leave 10 empty lines or just one empty line, it is the same as one empty line. Now, but inside math mode, you leave a space, you actually do not get a resulting space. Yeah. So, you, if you want a space, then you have to put slash comma or slash colon, slash semicolon, depending on how much space you want. Yeah. Quad and double Q. Quad have more amount of space. You can also have negative space with slash exclamation mark. Greek alphabets are extremely simple. Yeah, unlike math word, I have also used math word at various places. So if you want these Greek letters, you have to go to a certain lookup table and search there. You know that it is called alpha, but you have to search from what all is shown there, and we typically have plenty of such Greek letters. So here in LaTeX you just type alpha, slash alpha, every command has starts with a slash. So these are all very self explanatory. Also, when making a document, we would like to have a big list of references, a big list of bibliography. Yeah. So bibliography is an environment, the bibliography. Yeah. So you can begin the bibliography, end the bibliography. In the bibliography itself is more like an itemized. So here the items are called slash bib item. Then you have a label and then you have a name. Labels are the ones that will actually come in the margin for certain types of bibliographies. this being a little more advanced, we will do it if it is essential later. We can also pursue discussion of this on Moodle. So, like we have label and ref, when you have a label, you can keep referring to the label from different parts of the document using ref. If it is a bib item, then to refer to it, you will use slash site. This is an important difference. That way, you will refer to this particular item. If this particular item occurs as fifth in that list, then the number 5 will come where you use slash site name, it will come in square brackets. Again, you have to compile twice because all these label ref, label site, these are places time, these are all compilations where the first time it will obtain the numbers and second time it will put these numbers wherever they are cited, wherever they are referenced. Most important, presentations also, LaTeX is extremely well adapted for making very complicated fancy presentations. This presentation you are seeing is also made on Beamer. So, in the best part of using Beamer for LaTeX presentation, for presentations, is if you have typed all your mathematical formula with so much difficulty in LaTeX, then the same formula is directly you can take and put into a presentation. So, Beamer is something that again is built on LaTeX. So, the compilation everything is exactly the same, only now you should use document class Beamer. The best part of Beamer is because it is built on LaTeX, the entire LaTeX whatever is typed, all the commands, they are all used with hardly any change. So, one uses document class Beamer for this, and again to compile it, one uses PDF LaTeX or LaTeX. Now, the only information is we have to, in a normal LaTeX document, it knows when to flow from one page to next page. It knows depending on if this page is full, it will start flowing to the next page, but that is not how you make a PPT, that is not how you make a presentation. In a presentation, you have to say all this has to come in one slide, in one frame, then you go to the next frame and then you say all this should come into the next frame. So, here you have to tell very explicitly all the information between begin frame and end frame. There is also a theme, this while I am showing this mouse, there is this begin, the top part, yeah. There is also this lower part, the lower part is in blue, on the right side there is this page number, yeah, all this is part of the theme. Yeah, in Beamer you can also have all these links, hyperlinks for browsing, all this is related to a theme. Now, each frame can have its title, subtitle, you can have multiple things coming on the slide one after another, yeah, for that we use a pause command. Yeah, these are the important things. More about the Beamer can be seen using the Beamer user guide. Yeah. When we download Beamer package, automatically the Beamer user guide also gets downloaded, and that has a really good manual of the Beamer, and also it has many templates. So, that completes our LaTeX presentation. We have some time for questions. So, Kolhapur Institute of Technology can ask their question.
Can we have Roman numbers in enumerated list?
Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Any type of numbering is possible.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay, we will listen to a question from Periyar Manaimai Tanjavur.
But the doubt is,
yeah.
How to make IEEE format like a PDF file? Yeah, two columns.
Oh no, that's certainly possible. Document class IEEE TRAN, IEEE website, on IEEE transactions website, for example, they will list the class file, CLS file, and you have to just say document class IEEE TRAN. And that will make it to two columns default. You can make it to one column if you want, but two columns is default there. So, each journal has its own class file and one should use that class file in document class. So, we will take this question from Tanjavur now, from Shastra University, Tanjavur.
Can we include flash type animations in LaTeX?
Animations. If I understand right, you asked can we make animations in LaTeX? Right?
Right.
Only 2 months ago, I heard that one can make extremely complicated animations purely in LaTeX. One can also build circuits, inductors, capacitors, all in LaTeX. I do not know how to do it. There is one person called Sibiraj Pillai, who is also a faculty member in IIT Bombay. We will certainly arrange your meeting with him when you come here in 2 weeks. Yeah, I am sure it is possible. Thank you. One of the questions is, can we make a PPT in LaTeX? I understand PPT means PowerPoint presentation. Then the answer is no. Can you make just a presentation? Of course, Beamer is able to do that, and our presentation is all made on Beamer. One can make many very fancy complicated presentations purely in LaTeX by using Beamer. Converting that to Microsoft PowerPoint presentation is not possible. Yeah. Okay. There are many examples on Moodle. We will put them up on Moodle very soon. One of the questions was, can we get Roman numbers for enumerate? That is possible. There was one question about shell script. Yeah. Can you please ask the question again? We have 2-3 minutes for taking up one more question. Yeah. Please ask.
Sir, actually, I was not able to follow with that shell script, sir. The remaining things I am very clear.
Sure.
So I tried with that hash followed by exclamatory, so followed by forward slash bin slash bash, but it's not working in my system.
Were you the person who said that bash is not there, just sh is there in your system? Were you the person who said that only sh is there, bash is not there?
No sir, it is from Periyar Maniyame. I'm not.
Okay. Sure. See, we don't expect there is a problem if bash is working. See, you do like this, whether your bash is working fine or not, simple way to check is do control L, and if that clears the screen, that means bash is working on your computer.
Yes sir.
Okay, now what is
control L, it's working.
Okay, good. Specifically, what is it that is not working? There might be a small syntax error which we can see only if you put the exact code on Moodle.
No sir, I am confused with that bash programming.
Yeah, okay. Let us open that file and see. Yeah, we will open that file and see immediately after we take up this question. Meanwhile, can you just send me on chat which slide number of bash of using Linux tools? Yeah, please send that on chat while we take up this next question.
Okay sir, I will send. Yes sir, I
will. It's not possible anymore. Huh? Yeah.
Is LaTeX developed in Python?
No, LaTeX is not developed in Python. LaTeX was developed by one person called Knut. It has been around since 30 to 40 years, perhaps 40 years. It has been around since 40 years and it is not developed on Python. LaTeX is built on tech, to be precise. Let me speak to the person from Vellore Institute of Technology. We appreciate you telling us most of the things you have followed. There is only this specific thing that you have not followed. We will appreciate if you can write this on Moodle. Also, specifically with slide in bash, all that we will elaborate again perhaps tomorrow. Yeah. So, we prefer stopping here.